on their subjective preconceived notions. Next are teachers, who help create perceptions among thousands of vulnerable minds about disability. They are a crucial link, and there is a dire need to sensitize them with awareness to create better perceptions in next generation. The people in position of influence should show hope and not sorrow, and they are needed to do it now like never before. The next few pointers are for parents. I don't know how many of them are left, but the first one is assuming competence. It could be a child with high sensory needs and visual challenges, or a child with low muscle tone with no depth perception, or it could also be the one who is able to do almost everything but is non-verbal. Yet, the thing that can change each one of these kids' future and the collective perception of our children is us assuming competence in their abilities. Assume that they are capable of more. Whatever you are seeing around you are old theories. Your child is unique. Create your own reality. If one thing doesn't work, try another. If one program fails, find another. But keep moving. One thing that may change you and your child's future is stimulation and repetition. Shift the goalpost. Expect a little more and do a little more. Don't have a set notion or image of what your child can or cannot do. That's the biggest hurdle, because that image that you have in your mind is not your own. It has been contributed by media and age-old beliefs, and that may not be true in today's time and context. Assume that your child can and he will. The next is taking charge. Somebody has rightly said, either you run the life or life runs you. You've got the diagnosis, you've cried for months, gone through the denial, the guilt, the anger phase, now move on. Take control of your situation. You are the person who can change the destiny of your child. Research, learn, teach, train. Expect them to do more than what you've been told. Stop treating them like babies. Treat them as per their age. Stop believing anyone who says they can't speak more than one language. I know many who speak three. Expose them to situations, to people, to places. Stop asking only yes or no questions. Engage in high order thinking interactions. Teach social skills, socially appropriate behavior. Don't blame everything on Down syndrome. Many things can be blamed on poor parenting. Learn the difference and move on to the next skill. Make them part of conversations, outings, family events, critical discussions. Empower them with communication, verbal or non-verbal, and help them get better at it. Teach manners and establish negotiable and non-negotiable ground rules. In one sentence, take charge of your situation. The next is seeking guidance. I want to share a recent incident. Arshia, as you know, I keep sharing her videos. She is learning skating, and about 10 days ago, we were worried that she was losing interest in skating. She was making excuses, she didn't want to go, and we thought it was over. We spoke to the coach and he suggested that we change the wheels. Even though we had changed them less than 20 days ago, we tried to what the coach suggested, and something extraordinary happened. We suddenly had a new girl who was ready an hour before the class and didn't want to come back, who was now practicing 2 hours instead of one, and her passion was reignited. This incident became a light bulb moment for me. I wondered how many times we as parents blame it on the abilities and competence of the child and not the programs and methods with which we are teaching. Not looking for better alternatives. We are a huge population across the globe, and many parents and professionals are creating platforms and networks that make it easier for us to seek their guidance. Use that. The internet has made it so easy for us to ask questions for anyone who's even sitting across the continent. There are Down syndrome research institutes, writing, reading, learning programs, and many more resources that are out there in the world for you all to see. What is accessible now was not easily available when we started. So you have the chances of better potential increasing every single day. You don't need to do all, but you can always take trials. speak to people who have done these, and then make an informed choice. Read Glenn Doman's books. Read about neuroplasticity. Be aware. An aware parent is the empowered one. And the last point that I would want to make is challenge and expand the narrative. Internet is filled with photos of our children with sappy captions. Talent shows with our children dancing on Tare Zameen Par songs and judges and anchor crying. In our quest to create awareness, we somehow have started reinforcing the very stereotypes we have been fighting for. More often than not, our children are shown not for who they are. More often than not, our children are shown not for who they are, but what emotions they can evoke in general population. And it is not of inclusion. It is almost always of sympathy and pity. Which is why we as parents should be careful with the message that we are sending out in the world. 40 years ago, in the era of institutionalization, nobody would have imagined all that our children are achieving today. The reality of the narrative has changed from then, but it further needs to be changed and should shift from sympathy to equality. In the end, all that I would like to ask each parent here is to do one exercise when you go back home. Keep your hand on your heart and imagine the future you've already thought for your child. Once you have that image in front of you, take an invisible eraser and wipe that image off and build another one. One that is powerful and one that does justice to this ambition. Thank you. And now I would like to show the video.